agree with you, it was a very bad odor in the building. I walked through the whole building, but I have to say, the chief of facilities, he has had a plumbing crew out here.
What the parents and the staff are saying is true, and we gotta keep our children in school. So please take it back to Dr.
Initially, the problem originated in the staff bathroom. That's when
students,
2005, when students first go. And since then, it has proceeded to get worse. We have students, special needs students, who are walking through the school like this. In addition to that, we've had staff vomiting, taking off of work due to the smell and the odor. When the school found out that Dr. Callaway was coming, I see teams of people working on a problem. I see people investigating in breaks.
I bought masks for my students because they were complaining about the smell so bad. And as a matter of fact, some of my students complained of headaches.
My problem is I have a couple students in my room who are not coming to school. The bus drivers detaining these students from being picked up in the morning from anywhere from 9:15 to 10 o'clock in the morning and not delivering them until late at night. This has not just happened to my classroom, but to a number of students in our building.
On this letter regarding the financial emergency, it states that students' learning and achievement are suffering because of the district's financial turmoil. We have that to deal with. We have coming into work again with the no lights, no heat. I came into that this morning. My classroom doesn't have lights anymore. We need to raise the bar. Our bar is low if this is the best. This building is brand new, and it shouldn't be in the condition it's in.
We have students who had teachers who have decided they did not want to be at CMA for whatever reason. Those teachers left. Students are not receiving or did not receive grades for the first card marking. Now that may seem like a blessing. I'm not gonna give your child a grade. However, it does not ensure that my child learned anything in that first semester.
My daughter attends Jerry L. White. And my daughter has upper respiratory problems. She was admitted into Children's Hospital this evening. My real concern is, had that problem traveled from Jerry L. White to Renaissance, I'm more than sure something would have been done by then.
They have been out, I want to say, about 2 years. We had a teacher get robbed, it made the news, yet there's still no lights. And as of now, it's dark in the mornings. We have teachers come to work as early as 6 o'clock. We have students that start standing outside at 7:30. And those lights in the parking lot are
on. But we did all outside light. Facilities did. I was laid off. The truck I drive, that's what it does. It goes up and puts outside light. So you got rid of that job. So